Hello everyone, welcome to online learning. In this video, I want to go through a couple of very basic concept of programming languages, which is a pretty broad concept in and of itself. Right. Then, I am Lufia Jodsi, Assistant Professor of Computer Science Department in Jyoti Engineering College, Chennai. Now, moving on to topic. According to sequential addresses, in computer systems that reads or writes the information to the file sequentially, starting from the beginning of the file and proceeding step by step towards the end. Okay. Best example of the sequential addresses emulate the magnetic type operations. We already know that according to sequential addresses, it is proceeded the one record after the other. That means that first of all, record 1 is proceeded. After that, we can proceed record 2, then record 3, then etc. Okay, that is the sequential access method. By using the sequential access method, we know that the file pointer or the starting from the beginning of the file, we can proceed step by step towards the end. That is the main advantage of the sequential access method. And these are the supporting operations by the sequential access. First one is the read next. That means read record and move to the next position. Second one is the write next, write and advance the position. And third one is the rewind. We have a section, a rewind section after two more slides. In that section, I told about the what is the purpose of the rewind function in the file. Okay, in the rewind, moving back to the earlier location. And third, fourth one is the skip and records. That means that we can skip any number of the records. That is the main advantages or the main operations allowed by the sequential access files. Okay. Then the next topic is the random access. One information is, this is a university question. What is the features of the sequential access and the random access? Okay, please note these all notes. Okay, then according to the random access, the computer system can read or write the information anywhere in the data. That is based on the disk mode. For example, according to the disk working principle, we know that in the disk we can write the data anywhere as section by section. Okay, just like that, the random access can read or write the information anywhere in the data file. Okay, then user can jump to any record and access that record. That is the main point of the random access. That means that instead of one by one, it can jump one to any other particular number of the record. Okay, then the supporting operations are read and for reading the nth record, and write and writing the nth record. Jump to read and, that means jump to any number or EOF. What do you mean by the EOF? EOF is the end of the file. That means that the last position of that particular file. And next one, query content record, that is used to return back to this record later. After any time, after particular time, we can return back to this corresponding record. Okay, these are the functions or the operations of random access. Okay, next we are discussing about the advantages of random access and sequential access files. Okay, first of all, the sequential access advantages is when you access information in the same order all the time. Okay, that is the main advantage of sequential access. We can access information same as the file order. Okay, and the second one is the faster than the random access. Why? What is the reason of the faster? You know that in the sequential access method, we can proceed the record one by one, or one record is proceeded after the other. Okay, by this reason, this is the faster than the random access method. Okay, then the magnetic type storage devices are using the sequential access method. In our system, the magnetic tape storage devices are using the sequential access method. And next one is the random access. According to random access, you can search through it and find the data you need more easily. Okay, I already told that in the random access, user can jump to any records and access it. Okay. by the jumping procedure we can find out our record easily. So so the randomizers can search through it and find out the data you need more easily. Okay, the next one, in modern computer, hard disks are using the random access. Okay, in modern computer we can using the random access method because that is the more easy methods rather than the sequential access method. Okay, then next one, functions like fread and fwrite, which are used for all types of the file. We already know that in the functions operate file operations, fwrite, fread and fopen, fclose. In the fread and fwrite is used in all type of the files. Okay, but while other functions are specifically for the random access. Okay, what are the other functions? What are the other functions? These are the other functions: rewind, ftel, fseek, feof. These functions are also useful for which one? The random access files. Okay, then next topic is the file positioning functions. Are you heard about the file positioning function? Okay, the primary use of the file positioning function is in the processing of the random access. Okay, then second one is another use is for change the state the mode in which the file is opened after file. That means that if we are using the file for writing or writing operations, then by using this file positioning functions you can change the state to the read state. Okay, or if you are using the file for reading state, now you can change the state to the writing state. Okay, that is the main advantage of the file positioning functions, and these are the example for the file positioning. First one, rewind, ftel, fseek, feof, fwrite and fread. Okay, today we are going to discuss about three file positioning functions: rewind, ftel and fseek. According to first one, rewind function is used to reset the file position indicator to the beginning of a file specified. Okay, that means that whenever the file pointer is appear, the file position indicator will rewind or reset the indicator to the beginning of the file. That is the main meaning of the rewind function, and it rewinds the file if you want to read back a file just after writing the data to it. We can use the rewind function, that means f rewind. Then this is the syntax of rewind function: rewind of fx, fx is particular file pointer, and which resets or rewind the file pointer at to the beginning of that particular file by fx file pointer. Okay, then this is an example for you. In this example you can see that first of all include the header sections, then entered into the main section, then declared the file pointer by using the star operator, file star fp, then declared any one character type variable c. Then this is the syntax for f open or opening the file. First of all, this file.txt file is opened in with the help of the read mode. Then here we have a statement. This the meaning of the statement is whenever the e of f, that means that end of the file is encountered, up to that print the data. Okay, print the percentage of c comma c, then close this statement. Then next section is the rewind of fp. What is the meaning of this line? That means that moves the file pointer at the beginning of the file. That is the rewind fp. That means that fp is a file pointer. Rewind is used for to change the or reset or rewind the file position indicator to the beginning of that particular file. That is the beginning, that is the meaning of rewind of fp. Then for this function we have another statement, that is same as to the fopen statement. Here whenever the EOFF is encountered, add to that the print the data, then close that file, particular file, by using the fclose function, then get ch, then close the curly braces. Okay, this is the one simple program for the rewind function. Now let us check what is the corresponding output of this particular program. Okay, we cannot compile this code because here I am using some particular online C compiler instead of any particular applications. If you have the particular application, please encounter or please execute this program and please check what is the result of this particular program. Okay, then the output of this particular program is just like this. If file.txt has the content hello, then the corresponding output will be hello hello. Okay, why the result is just like this? Do you know? In this example, first one hello is printed because the file.txt has a content hello. The second hello means that whenever we are called the rewind of fp, the file pointer is going to the beginning section of that particular file, then once again it printing that characters. Okay, so the result is just like this, hello hello. Okay, so the next file positioning function is ftel. What is the purpose of ftel? This function tells you the current position of the file position indicator in the file relative to the beginning of the file. That means that it must be tells the current position of that particular file, and it is also used to tell about how many characters there exist in that particular file. Okay, it will return the number of the bytes from the beginning of the file. The syntax of that corresponding function is ftel of fx. Fx is a file pointer. Then it will return 0 if the file position indicator is at the beginning of the file pointed by fx. Then we can use the ftel function to get the total size of the file. I already told about this. It is also used to tell about how many characters are exist there. Okay, then we can use the seek and constant to move the file pointer at the end of the file. Okay, this is the ftel function. Then this is example of ftel. In this example, it is checks the how many number of the characters will exist there. In this example, we open the file for the reading procedures. Then fseek of fp comma 0 comma secant. Okay, 0 is representing the beginning of the particular file. Then secant is also used for to move the end file pointer at the end of the file. Okay, then fp the file pointer, then length is equal to ftel of fp. That means that we can find out how many number or the how many characters are present in that particular file. Then close that file by using the fclose, then print that function. Okay, for example, sample output in the file.txt we have the content just like this is a sample text. Then output of this program is 21 bytes. In this example, we already encountered or we already take the free space. That means that the gap between this and is. Okay, then the gap between is and a, we already take this space. So the total length of this particular file is 21 bytes. Okay, this is a particular example by using the ftel function. Next we enter to the third file positioning function, that is the fseek function. The fseek function is used to position the file position indicator to a specified position in the file. The statement fseek of fx comma 4 into size of float comma 0. Okay, which means that it would be move the file position indicator by 16 bytes. That means 4 times the size of float. Size of float is 4, so 4 into 4 is equal to 16. That means the position indicator would move by 16 bytes. Okay, from the beginning of the file pointed by the f of x. How can we find out that we are thinking the file beginning of the file pointer by the help of this 0? Okay, then to move the other example, to move the indicator by 50 bytes from the current position, it can be used fcof fx comma 50 bytes comma 1. Okay, the third argument 1 is stand for the current position, then the value 2 is stands for the end of the file, the position, the value 0 is stand for the beginning of the file. Okay, these are the three arguments. Then here are three constants used in the fseek function for when seek sid, seeker and seek end. That means that it denotes the end of the file, and second one denotes the starting of the file, and seeker is denotes the file pointer's current position. Okay, then the example of this corresponding function, fseek function. First of all, hash include stdio.h entered into the main section. File pointer is declared by using the star operator. Then open the file myfile.txt with write operand or write mode. Then its content is just like this. This is Java point, and we need to move the 8 bits beginning of that particular file by using the seek set. What is the meaning of the seek set? Seek set means that it denotes the starting of the file. Other than we can use the zero value here. Okay, we already know that zero value is used to, that means this from the size of the file pointed by the fx. Okay, so this particular line we can write this just like this, fseek of fp comma 8 comma 0. Okay, then we are put the characters just like this, so no JSON. Okay, then close that particular file. Then sample output of this program is this is SonoJSON. That means that this 8 bytes or the 8 position from the first content is taken and copied into the second content. That is the purpose of fc function. I repeat, the 8 bits from the first content is copied and paste, or it will be rendered in the second content. Okay, that is the particular example of using the fseek functions. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.